8th edition of Marex Maritime News. The headlines on Monday, the 22nd of March 2021. World trade set to rise in 2021. FIEO launches online portal to ease search for elusive shipping containers. Along with experiencing a dip in business. Container shortage persists, slows Indian exports growth. Panama requests IMO mediation for sorting out seafarer crisis in Chinese ports. The industry is expected to benefit from the world trade recovery in 2021, with average seaborne trade volumes expected to end above pre-pandemic levels. But underlying differences are significant.
World trade in 2021. Higher spot earnings are driving nominal period rates higher, which gives owners the choice of riding their luck in the spot market or locking in earnings for a few months, a year, or even longer. The one-year time charter rate for a modern eco 180,000 deadweight is now $22,250 a day, which is 24% firmer than the 18,000 level of early 2021. These are big moves in such a short period of 3 months. Naturally, these higher earnings are generating some frantic interest in the second-hand sale and purchase market. The sellers' price ideas may be adjusted upwards each day, leaving the buyers chasing shadows. The buyer can accept sellers last but still get short-jumped by a competitor willing to pay over the asking price. Normal ethical behavior is often suspended. Sellers may decide to fix their ship out on charter instead of selling, taking jam today and maybe harvesting honey tomorrow. There have been instances of buyers bidding well in excess of the asking price as the only way of nailing jelly to the wall. We have not seen such antics since Lehman went down. We are in the early stages of a demand recovery with some way to go before we get back to end 2019 levels. Chinese government is looking to tone down its own shocking spending and rising internal debt, which is known to very limited people as the media is controlled. Much has been made about the falling rate of net new tonnage supply, and it is indeed a key part of the current recovery. And the story is good for the next 2 years. In 2023 and beyond, newly placed orders will deliver. Hopefully, demand for steel scrap will stay strong as electric arc furnaces replace blast furnaces at the margin. Recycling market activity was extremely limited. The market has been subdued so far in 2021, and the short-term outlook appears uncertain. The pace of vaccination progress and lifting of restrictions highlighted as downside risk. German industrial production fell by 3.8% year-on-year in January, its steepest year-on-year decline since September of 2020. Chinese iron ore imports rose by 3% year-on-year across January-February of this year, indicating a fairly firm start to the year, although recording a somewhat cooler rate of expansion than the average 10% year-on-year growth recorded across second half of 2020. Markets are being pushed and pulled by the vagaries of supply and demand, overlaid by the disruptive impact of the pandemic on both. It is unusual that smaller unit earns more than larger, but the smaller ships do have the better supply and demand side dynamics. We are seeing a two-tier market for the handysize. While last week trumpets of joy were blown in owners' offices, this week half of them were muzzled. Some blame this to the evil eye of the supra owners, which fell on them when they realized that their larger ladies were earning less than their smaller cousins. But what is normal anymore? As long as this bullish market remains, it seems as though it's win-win for owners and in particular for handy-sized players. Sell high and surely make a pretty penny, or sit back and enjoy the ride provided by the higher rate. Having seen the firmness and rise in the spot present market, the expert panel of brokers who write the FFAs have a contrary story to show as below. The Baltic forward assessment values for Capesize and period business as of 21st March was 17,950 a day. For calendar for first quarter 2022 is projected as 13,063 a day. Calendar of 23 at 15,694 a day. Calendar 25 at 13,663 a day. For Panamax 82,000 size, on 21st March, it was rated as 23,630 a day. For quarter 1, 22, 13,980 a day. Calendar 23, only 13,183 a day. Panamax 74, on 21st March at 22,294 a day. Calendar 23, only 11,847 a day. And calendar 25, even below at 9,963 a day. Supramax values for March 21st was 22,570 a day. Calendar 23 at 11,382 a day. Calendar 25, only 9,900 a day. Where and in what should one have faith in, therefore? I leave the question in your minds.
To overcome the current shortage of shipping containers that threatens to cripple India's trade, the Federation of Indian Exports Organization, FIEO, has set up an online first-level marketplace for containers, bringing together both exporters and shipping lines, and is aimed at easing the flow of outbound goods.
The immediate objective of launching the container demand e-module is to address the shortage of containers which is plaguing India's exports. We have asked our exporter to be better prepared and put their requirement in advance, as spot booking is almost impossible. This also helps the shipping line and the freight forwarder to come forward and address those requirements. So on the one hand, it gives the shipping line freight forwarder a better assessment of the container requirements by the shippers, and on the other hand, it helps the shipper also to get better choice and more competitive rates. Over 75% of the queries put on the platform has been responded within 24 hours, but we have yet to see how much is actually fructifying in the real business. We are pretty sure that in times to come, this e-module may be developed as a marketplace for container indenting and supply.
The world's largest ship recycling yard at Alang in Gujarat is experiencing a sudden slump in business over the past couple of months, as ship recyclers in neighboring Pakistan and Bangladesh are offering higher prices for vessels coming for dismantling.
Hindustan Institute of Maritime Training.
Responding to poor February 2021 export figures, FIEO President Sharad Kumar Saraf has said that monthly exports rose only marginally by 0.67% to $27.93 billion, mainly on account of container shortages across the country and supply disruptions in the last week of the month. This is mainly due to increasing COVID cases in certain states. The Republic of Panama, the first registry of ships with more than 8,500 vessels, that together exceeds 230 million gross registered tons, representing approximately 16% of the world maritime fleet, and with approximately 318,000 seafarers on board, has requested the collaboration of the Secretary General of the IMO, Mr. Kai Tak Lim, to mediate and assist seafarers and shipowners regarding the crisis involving ships in the Far East.
Captain Parampal Singh Sidhu, first cadet captain of T.S. Dufferin and founder of CMMI Chandigarh, passed away after a cardiac seizure on the 21st of March. He was 79. He is much grieved by his family and his batchmates.
Stay safe, stay healthy. Thank you for watching. See you next Monday.